It's time to find the fees.
Well, this segment is Find the Fees, and it's important to know what fees you're paying on your investments out there. So we've got a little bit of a short segment here, about 5 minutes. I often hear everyone say, well, annuities are terrible. Annuities are terrible. Well, there's all kinds of different annuities, really. And, you know, one of the ones that I think have given people such a bad taste in their mouth is something called the variable annuity. And so, Danny, I'm going to go to you first. There's a lot of different fees that you can have inside a variable annuity. Isn't that right? I mean, talk about the M&E fees.
Yeah. So the first fee we want to talk about today is something called the mortality and expense fee, or the M&E fee. And that's a fee that the insurance company will charge to protect the insurance company against unexpected events. So the insurance company is going to, one of the things about a variable annuity is income. Well, in order for the insurance company to provide that income, they have to charge something to protect against unexpected events, and that is the M&E fee. And usually it charges somewhere around 1.5%, is 1.25% to 1.5%.
And so, you know, what gets me is with the world that we live in where everything has to be disclosed, you know, oftentimes people think, well, I don't get charged that because I don't see it on my statement, and they don't really see it on their statement, do they?
No, they don't. No, it's actually something that is going on in the background. Those real thick books that they send you once a year to read. And I understand that people just cancel their social hour to read those books from cover to cover. And that's not true. People don't read those prospectuses by and large, but that's where the insurance company is disclosing those fees.
Now, not all variable annuities have this, but an overwhelming majority do typically, right?
That's correct.
So when we see these that have the M&E fees, we always want to dig into it and make sure we're finding out if this fee is there and figuring out how much it is. And sometimes we have to call the company to even find out what that is. And then you see someone being a little, their blood pressure going up as you're having that conversation because they have no idea it's there. Then Larry, there's another fee as well, right?
Right. You always want to know in those variable products what the subaccounts, what those fees are. And believe it or not, they have an M&E fee as well. Most of the time. Now, different ones will work different ways, but they have administrative fees, they have distribution charges, which basically those distribution charges is promotions, is what those are to attract new buyers. They have transfer in excess of the free amount. They have a lot of different fees, and just the sub-accounts alone can have a fee anywhere from 0.25% to 3%.
3%. That's crazy. So now, I mean, let's just call it 1% on average for a sub-account. So if we got about 1% on the M&E, and that's being probably generous, and then we've got 1% on the sub-account, we're already now at 2% on these fees. And again, right, they're not listed out this way.
No, they're inside of the funds. And so it's really just dragging down the performance of your fund, but you're paying them.
Yeah. And so how does someone even find out what these sub-account fees would be? And basically all a sub-account is, right, is a mutual fund. But it's just called a different name inside the variable annuity.
That's true. That they are. But you can find those fees by digging into actual reports about. Now, it's hard to find. The average investor, even Googling it, they're going to have difficulty trying to find it. But if they go to a financial professional, we're fluent in this and we can show you exactly how to find it.
And it sometimes takes a little bit of time, but it's a little bit of like a murder mystery, a Columbo kind of thing, digging it through. Then there's sometimes rider fees. I mean, and those rider fees can be income related, death benefit related, long-term care related. Oh, you want your money back in case the market takes a dive. That's called return of premium. And sometimes that's a rider. So, I mean, you know, it's not uncommon when we see a variable annuity for someone to be paying anywhere from 2 to 3+% every year on this. And it doesn't get listed out that way.
Right.
Where we don't work with typically loaded annuities, variable annuities at all. We have a no load variable annuity we work with.
Right.
And if that's a tool we need to use, it's never that high. In fact, our highest fee is 1.5 on the high end, 0.6 down on the low end. And they're getting legal and tax advice with that as well. Yes. So if you need help with any of this and want to know what you're being charged, reach out to 833-888-4687 and we'll get the help you need there.